Good morning, students. We were reading the chapter The Little Girl, and we have read so far that the little girl Kezia, she is very much afraid of her father. She was so much afraid that she even avoided to talk to him whenever she got the chance to talk. And there were four members in the house: her mother, father, and grandmother, and Kezia. So Kezia really do not want to talk to her father or her parents, but her grandmother forced her to talk to them because they really do not have some good conversations or nice conversations. So one Sunday afternoon, when her grandmother forced her to come down, to go down and to talk to her parents, she just came down, and then she really don't have any conversation with them. Why? Because her mother was just sitting on the sofa reading something and her father was just sleeping. So this happens all the time. She really do not have such a nice conversations with her parents. She really do not have a cordial relationship with her parents. So what happens? One day grandmother asked her to present a surprise gift to her father. So she just tried to make a beautiful cushion of pink color for her father. She sewed the cushion, but she didn't find anything to stuff in the cushion. So what she did, she just went to her father's room and she just collected some papers, and she really didn't know that these papers were very important for her father, but she just tore them papers and stuffed those papers into the cushion and sewed it. And that's how she made a beautiful present, according to her, beautiful present to her father. But she never knew that those papers were very much important for her father. And then those papers were searched in the whole house, and then finally they come to know that, you know, those papers were stuffed in the cushion by daughter Kezia. And then father was very much upset with Kezia and he sent her to sleep. Then what happened next? Crying too much to explain, she lay in the shadowed room watching the evening light make a sad little pattern on the floor. Then father came into the room with a ruler in his hand. So what? She was sent to the room, to her room, to sleep. She was put to sleep by her mother, but she was just there crying in her room. She cried a lot. She really wanted to explain that what she has done, why she has done, but nobody listened to her. And then she just lay in the shadowed room. She was just sitting in the room without any light, and evening light of outside doors and outside light. The light was making beautiful patterns in the floor, and she was just sitting there. She was just watching those patterns. And what happened? Then suddenly father came into her room and he got a ruler in his hand. So what he said, "I'm going to beat you for this," he said. "Oh no, no," she screamed, hiding under the bedclothes. And her father came to teach her a lesson. So he brought a ruler with her and he said that he is going to beat her with this ruler. And she screamed. She just, you know, shouted that she really do not want to be beaten by her father. She said, "Oh no," and she just hid under her bedclothes. Quilt or something like that, blanket. He pulled them aside and he pulled those blankets, those bedclothes aside, and he just ordered her to sit up. "Sit up," he ordered, "and hold out your hands. You must be taught once and for all not to touch what does not belong to you." And he just ordered Kezia just to sit up and just hold your hand, just stretch your hands outward. And he said that you have to be told a lesson once and for all. Once and for all means forever. Once and for all means forever. So you must be taught a lesson forever that you should not touch those things which really do not belong to you. So what happened then? But it was for her birthday. She really wanted to explain that why she has done this, because she wanted to give him a pleasant surprise on his birthday, but it never gone so. So what she said, she told him that, you know, it was for your birthday, but she couldn't say it all. And then down came the ruler on her little pink palms. Hours later, when grandmother had wrapped her in a shawl and rocked her in the rocking chair, the child clung to her soft body. And then all things just went on. Then after that, So ruler came on her little pink palms, and she was beaten by her father. And then after some hours, when she was quiet, when she gave up sobbing and everything was normal, then she just went to her grandmother. Grandmother wrapped her in her shawl and rocked her, and she just rocked her in a rocking chair. And then Kezia just clung to the soft body of her grandmother, and just she asked a question to her. "What did God made fathers for?" she sobbed. She again started sobbing and she asked a very innocent question that why God has made fathers for. So what is the role of the father according to God? "Here's a clean hanky, darling. Blow your nose. Go to sleep, pet. You will forget all about in the morning. I tried to explain to father, but he was too upset to listen tonight. So her grandmother didn't answer for that. Why? Because she knew that she couldn't understand that what is the importance of the fathers in our life. So she just tell her that, you know, just blow out your nose and just go to sleep. Your pet means dear. Okay, just go to sleep, dear. And she said that you are just a kid. You will forget it by the morning. By the morning, you will just forget all those things. And she said that I tried to explain everything to your father, but he was so much upset that he really do not want to listen anything tonight. So she said that just give time to your father and to yourself, everything will come to normal. And then, but the child never forgot. Next time she saw him, she quickly put both hands behind her back and a red color flew into her cheeks. But the child never forgot. She never forgot. Why? Because she really did not have a very good relationship with her father. And when she tried to, she was treated very brutally. She was treated very very badly, and she couldn't forget that. And next time, whenever she saw her father, she quickly put her both hands behind her back, and she was reddened by her face was reddened by her cheeks were reddened. Why? Because she was so much afraid of her father, and she just said that maybe she again be beaten by her father. But the child, it is done. The McDonald's lived next door. They had five children. Looking through a gap in the fence, the little girl saw them playing tag in the evening, the father with the baby Mao on his shoulder, two little girls hanging on his coat pockets, ran round and round the flower beds, shaking with laughter. Once she saw the boy turn the hose on him, and he tried to catch them laughing all the time. So McDonald's is a family which lived near their house, next to their house, and they were very happy family. And she saw them playing with their father through a gap in the fence. Fence, you know, that is surrounding that wall which is made around the house, that fence. And she saw them playing through a gap in the fence. And what she saw that a little girl, Shigeza, saw them playing a tag. Tag is a game, a kind of a game. They were playing game tag in the evening. The father had a baby Mao with him on his shoulders, and the two girls were hanging with his coat pockets, and he is just, you know, making them go round and round on the flower, round the flower beds, shaking with laughter. They all were laughing, they all were enjoying playing with each other. Once she saw the boys turn. And the boys turned the hose on him, and he tried to catch them laughing all the time. And then when father's turn came to catch them, he just catched them, and they were all laughing. They were all playing wholeheartedly with each other. So then what happened? Then it was she decided there were different sort of fathers. And then she got to know that there is a category of father. There are different kind of fathers. There are different types of fathers according to her. Suddenly one day mother became ill, and she and grandmother went to hospital. The little girl was left alone in the house. The Alice the cook. So what happened? See, according to she said that, you know, there were different sort of fathers according to her. Why? Because one was her father, who is very strict, you know, who didn't have time to play with her, didn't even have a time to talk to her. And on the one side there is McDonald's family, where the father is very much cheerful, father is playing with his kids and all. And so according to her, there are different types of father, and her father is one of them. Suddenly one day mother became ill. So what happened? One day her mother became ill, and her mother and her grandmother have to go to hospital together. And then that little girl were left alone in the house with the cook. That was all right in daytime. For daytime it was all good for her, because she was just busy in playing or doing her homework or some kind of a thing. So it was very easy for her. But while Alice was putting her to bed, she grew suddenly afraid. But it was all good for her in daytime. But at night, she was again afraid. She was very much afraid, and it was very hard for her to sleep alone or to just go to bed alone. See, this is a picture of McDonald, father, and those children, his kids. They were playing with him together. And here, Kezia is just looking through the fence, and she is just saying that she is just thinking that McDonald is another different type of father. In contrast with her father. So this happened. This is all for today. Just read this chapter and read it carefully.